Shalom, shalom. It's Tehillah from the Kfar with our bi-weekly Hebrew verbs lesson. And we are continuing to conjugate pa'al verbs in the past tense. And this week, I'm going to show you how to conjugate those words with two-letter roots. All right, and we're going to use the verb to sing, lashir, to illustrate that. So before we get started, I just want to remind you that I have free verb conjugation charts available on the website for both past and present tense. So the link is in the description and you can download as many as you need and use it for these videos and then also your study that you do outside of this. All right, so now let's go over the exercises that I gave you in the last video. So we learned how to conjugate the acha verbs, and these are verbs where the middle letter of the shoresh is an aleph, he, chet, or ayin. And we use the verb le'ehov, to love, as our example verb. So your first exercise was lish'ol, which is to ask. When you get rid of the lamed and the vav, that gives us a shoresh of sha'al, which is the same as hu. So hu sha'al, he asked. Sha'alti, I asked. Sha'alta, you asked, masculine. Sha'alt, you asked, feminine. Sha'alnu, we asked. Sha'altem, you all, masculine, asked. Sha'alten, you all feminine asked. And then for he and him, hen, we have sha'ala, she asked, he sha'ala, and him sha'alu, they asked, or hen sha'alu, they asked feminine. All right, so we have an additional a sound in the middle because these are acha verbs. The next verb was livchor, which is to choose. Our shoresh is bachar, and remember that if you have one of the softer letters, that's the beginning letter of the shoresh, like vet or chaf or fe, when you're conjugating it, if it remains the first letter of the word, then you have to switch it to the harder version. So the vet will become a bet, the chaf will become a kaf, the fe will become a pe, because we don't have vet or fe or chaf as the beginning letters of words. So hu bachar, he chose, that's the shoresh. Bacharti, I chose. Bacharta, you chose, masculine. Bachart, you chose, feminine. Bacharnu, we chose. Bachartem, you chose, plural masculine. Bacharten, you chose, plural feminine. And then we have he bachara and him bacharu, also hen bacharu. And your last verb was livot, which is to kick. Ba'at, same here with bachar, the vet is going to become a bet. So we have hu ba'at, he kicked. Ba'atti, I kicked. Ba'atta, you kicked. Ba'at, you feminine kicked. Anachnu ba'atnu, we kicked. Ba'attem, you masculine plural kicked. Ba'atten, you feminine plural kicked. And then he ba'ata, and him, hen ba'atu. If you have questions on this, let me know in the comments below and I will do my best to assist you. All right, so now for the two-letter roots. You'll notice here that instead of our usual three boxes, we have two boxes, and that's because we only have two letters of our root. And so instead of having an a sound pattern for most of the pronouns, we're going to have an a sound pattern. So just one a instead of two. And then for he, it's going to be a. So it's going to be essentially who and he are going to be the same words, the same conjugations that they are in the present tense, and you'll see when I do the example. And him and hen is going to be a'u. Okay, so a'a for he and a'u for him and hen. So our example verb is lashir, which again means to sing. Get rid of the lamed and the yod, and we have shar. So ani sharti. Okay, instead of a'a, it's just one a. So sharti, I sang. Ata sharta, you sang, masculine. At shart, you sang, feminine. Anachnu sharnu, we sang. Atem shartem, you all, masculine plural, sang. And aten sharten, you all, feminine plural, sang. All right, now for who is just our shoresh. So hu shar, he sang. He shara, she sang. And hem hen sharu, they sang. Okay, so ani sharti, ata sharta, at shart, anachnu sharnu, atem shartem, aten sharten, hu shar, he shara, hem hen sharu. So your exercises are going to be what they usually are, to use what you learned to conjugate these three verbs that I'm going to give you in the past tense. Your first verb is larutz, which means to run, and then lariv, which is to fight or argue, and lagur, which is to live. Not to live life, but to live in like a location, like ani gara be North Carolina. I live in North Carolina. Okay, so when you get rid of the lamed and either the vav or the yod in the middle, then you're just going to have one ah sound in the past tense pattern instead of two. And then the masculine and feminine present tense is going to match the who and he in the past tense. Anyway, do your best. If you have questions, let me know. Toda la tzfia. Thank you for watching. Again, you can email me, comment below. And if you like the video, share it. Subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you next week for vocabulary and the week after that for our follow-up verbs lesson. Shalom.